We have been tasked by a lovely couple here today to help them realize their dream wedding and legalize their marriage rights today. And since we are instrumental in doing so, we felt it's our legal obligation as well to remind them as they face this new chapter in their lives, the duties and responsibilities mandated by law. And we also deem it important to share to our couple some practical insights on married life. And this will also go to other married couples here. Simply because, just like other successful couples, we want them to live happily ever after. So, Mitsuru and Lanka, we want you to enjoy all the blessings of a happy married life. Because this is what God wants. And this is His will for you to bind yourselves forever. However, God made His ways for you to find each other is another story. It's another miracle that only Him knows. And aside from God, this is what our state wants. For you to live forever as spouses, as a family, a happy family. And so the state wants you to be reminded of the legal side of marriage here in the Philippines. Because as you know, in this country, there is no turning back. You know that. There's no turning back here. Okay. So these are your duties under the law. Number one. Well, this was taken from the book, The Family Law, by attorney Katrina Ligarda. I will not expound on each item. These are all self-explanatory. Number one, you have the duty to live together in one home. You have the duty to observe mutual love and respect. You have the duty to observe mutual fidelity. You have the duty to render mutual help and support. You have the duty to manage the household. You have the duty to support the family. You have the duty to fix the domicile. On the other hand, these are your rights as a couple under the law. The right to cohabitation, the right to sexual intimacy, the right to procreate, the right to jointly exercise parental authority over the children, the right to be supported by the other spouse, the right to be loved and be comforted, the right to jointly fix the family residence, the right to manage the household, the right to exercise any legitimate profession, the right to give and receive moderate gifts to and from each other, the right to retain the ownership, possession, and administration of your exclusive separate properties. We will not go on, these are all complicated now. So there you go, those are your duties and rights as a couple. So if any of you fail to fulfill these duties prescribed by law, there are remedies provided by law, but we will not share them with you anymore because we don't want you to reach that point. Because you have chosen wise men and women here, played by your principal sponsors, to be your second parents, to guide you, to help you. So to our dear principal sponsors, may we remind you that you are not just witnesses here today as required by law. You are not just here to provide honeymoon package for a house and lot as they start their new family. There is a more serious reason for your selection as your witnesses. You are chosen to be their honorary parents because of your wisdom, because of your standing in life, because of your many experiences in life. And they want to learn a lot from you. So your role here does not end after this celebration. So this time we'd like to see the principal sponsors chosen by our couple. Can you please stand? Our dear principal sponsors, you have a deeper role in their lives today. In the eyes of God, in the eyes of the law, and in the eyes of our community, that you will always ensure the happiness and togetherness of this couple. That you will always be there for them at any time of the day when things go wrong. That you will do everything in your wisdom and experience to help them make the right decision. Are you ready to face this obligation? Just please raise your hands. Tinatanggap niyo po ang prigas ng ito. Maraming pong salamat. Palakpakan naman po natin sila. Salamat po. Yale joined forces on the principal sponsors together with the help of their family. Because if you are all unsuccessful in doing so, the state shall intervene to resolve their differences. Huwag niyo pong hayaan dumating sa puntong iyon. Okay. In closing, let me share with you a short story. In our family time, we used to watch movies, and one of those movies are Crazy Stupid Love, starring Steve Carell and Julianne Moore. If you have watched it, maganda story. Si Kyle Weaver is living the American dream. He has a good job, a beautiful house, great children, and a beautiful wife named Emily. The movie was filled with fun, laughter, and what it's like to have a very good and happy family. Kyle's seemingly perfect life unravels, however, when he learns that Emily has been unfaithful and wants a divorce. The kids were greatly affected. The entire family relationship became a disaster that no one has ever imagined. But there was one person in the family who keeps on believing that his spouse was his soulmate, and what he feels was true love, and that's the husband. So he worked on to save his family. So he tries hard and harder to save the family. And as we were seeing all his efforts to save his marriage, to save his family, me and my wife both moved into tears. So, pakayap yung story. Why? Because only the husband is fighting for the marriage. So at the closing part of the movie, the husband says, the true love is being worked out. We don't work out on true love. True love does not come naturally. It is being worked out together, the two of you. Because in times of trouble, when only one of you is fighting, you're only one standing, you're just human, you can become weak, you cannot stand because of your weaknesses. But when it is the two of you fighting together, you can stand stronger. And when you have children, how many children do you want to have? Not sure yet, okay. When you have children, of course, your home will be standing stronger together. Okay? And don't let that home destroy by any typhoon or strong wind. Okay? Can you look at each other? Mitsuru, make sure that before you start your day that you look at that face alone. No other face that you will see when you open your eyes in the morning. Look at her. Blanca, same as you. Before you close your eyes in the evening, don't let other face, yung ibang mukha ang makita mo. Dapat yung mukha niya ang makikita mo when you close your eyes. Okay? Tandaan mo, tingin ka ulit sa kanya. Okay. And finally, Mitsuru and Blanca, you should be the source of strength of each other. For Mitsuru, you should be the source of her strength when she is weak and not to put her down. And Blanca, you should be the source of his strength when he is weak, not to put him down as well. You should be her voice when she can't speak. You should be his voice when he can't speak. And you should be her shelter from the storm when things go wrong with her. And you should be his shelter as well from the storm when things go wrong with him. So remember, true love is being worked out. That's the secret of living happily ever after. Would you like me to offer a song for you? I will not finish the song. I will expound what I have just said here. Okay? Would you like to sing also, right? And remember to sing this song when things go wrong. Okay? magic sing na? Okay. Remember this. I found.